number of weeks ago. At the time, his interest is in oxygen supply, oxygen delivery systems. But during that visit, he had made mention that he was interested to see us refurbish and rejuvenate the elevators. At the time, we had told him that yes, we are having some challenges, but we're working with stakeholders and partners in the private sector, in this case, our elevators and Shin, to try and see how we can resolve it. As you are aware, we had a report this morning, which is, I think more or less prompted us. We have a sit down to give the minister an idea of the plans we have to get all our elevators up and running, safe for use for private patients and staff. So this afternoon, it's for the minister to meet our partners who are working with us to resolve this particular. So I'd like to invite the cabinet secretary to make a few statements, and then invite the minister to deliver his speech for this afternoon.
Care. Where they came out. First time I came here, for my sister to work, I mentioned about it. And today I've seen him like this. We thank you, superintendent, for the effort that you have been making. Put things into order, except you're handicapped. Out of 14, you have an attempt. But the problem again, procurement procedures are still tedious. We should have shortcuts for certain things, especially for places like hospitals. You deal with emergencies. Every small thing, you know, get this tender authority, get that. This is what is bringing us to where we are. Out of 14, I'm told only one is operation.
President, yes.
Sad story. You attempted with your little money from Nima. But we are here. One, and first, I wanted to hear from the contractors, those from Zara elevators. If you have been here long, I know Mr. Piri. Don't you retire?
Yes, he is.
If you ask him about me, I've been around in government, starting from when I was a civil servant. With the one who used to repair, service our elevators somewhere where I can't mention. Anyway, I used to force of the president. Those elevators have been functional since then. When I was provincial minister in the southern province, we put up those elevators there. Today, I've had no problems. The mental development, where I served as a deputy minister, put up there. I want to hear from you whether the action that are taking now is temporal or there is a permanent solution. I'll come to you. Why am I saying this? They are for a bit of spares. Because we don't want what is happening in the streets. Today you find there are robots. Give them 1 week. They are gone. Gone forever. They will attempt again the week, but not here. This is life-saving institution. The traffic is heavy. Heavy. We need a solution. We need to find out what is your take, my advice, and happy. You have a new engineer here. I want also to find out, Mr. P, if you transfer this skill in you. If one man could call at any time. Now we are joined with the other colleagues from this other company. Shindwe. We want to hear from you because we want to resolve this matter. First of all, in the meantime, what solution do we have? In the mid-term, in the long term, we want to resolve this issue. You are to deliver service before, but I'm told your spares have to come from all the way from China. I think I'll pause here for the time being. I want to hear from our colleagues. They will interact here. If they continue with the old ones, because the onus is on you. I don't want to hear tomorrow. You service them 2 weeks later, they are broken down. If it's a temporary measure, tell us. This is just a permanent solution with this. I have said it, I've got credibility for the vendors. I know you. What you have been doing. If it's your product, can you assure us? Yes, move ahead.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thank you very much for giving us this opportunity. First and foremost, I need to clarify a few things. As you may be aware, the South Elevators represents the number one lift company in the world. That is what it is. We used to have Otis Elevators in the past year at UTH, and they used to run until their lifespan ended. I think I wasn't around. Like you have said, it was Mr. Kiri who was the MD. I don't know how we lost that contract. I think from what I've been taught, the elevators that are there are more field elevators, MOVI.
What do you mean?
They are more field elevators.
MOVI.
Oh. These are not Otis elevators. Oh. But we were approached on the 19th of July this year. We signed a contract to just revive temporarily these elevators. On the 20th, our engineer did come in to make an assessment, and management team was magnanimous to give us everything that we needed. We checked the elevators and we gave them the location. Well, we had already given them the location, and we had signed the contract on the 19th. So what has actually happened is we are simply trying to revive the elevator, which are not what is. And like you have said, we did revive the kitchen. We promised management that we were going to work on two while we were sourcing for spares from China, where Movie has a factory. So we revived the kitchen unit, and right now I've been gladly informed by our engineer that the E-block lift will be done by tomorrow. So like you said, Mr. Minister, it's a temporal arrangement. We have already been given some money, and we have ordered spare parts which are coming in the second week of next month. And we should be able to revive four elevators. But how long it will take for this to be operational, we'll have to see. But like you have said, if the government injected money in UTH, we will be able to bring in robust elevators. What is, if you went to Bank of Zambia, some of the elevators there have been there for over 40 years. That's how robust the Otis elevators are. They are long lasting. But I think because of competition, they have also reduced their lifespan. Because you can't have an elevator running for 40 years, it won't take your money. So even what you
see is your life, but also you
So what is has also reduced the lifespan to 20 years. But at least 20 years is better than some of these lifts you actually see in the buildings that you go to, which only last maybe for 2 years or 10 years. Yeah. Right now, for your own information, we've been able to install escalators that have been down at Levy Park for more than 3 years. And now Sadiq come to us and we have installed escalators. They've been down for more than 3 years. And we have put in what is escalators. I would have actually talked about other escalators and elevators that we've been able to put in the country. I should actually mention here that South Elevators is only owned by Zambians. So the only outflow of foreign currency is the manufacture of these escalators and elevators. And money, the profit that we make, will actually stay in this country. Unlike probably some of our competitors who are outsiders. I think I should stress, we represent the number one elevator company in the world. You can Google If you are doubting, go and Google, you will be able to attest to what I'm attesting. So any other escalator and elevator is simply second class.
Mr. Ouma again?
Kabuma Davis.
Kabuma
Davis. Kabuma. It's pronounced as Kabuma. Oh, then I will say Kabuma. Kabuma.
Kabuma.
Yeah, so this is what we are trying to do. We were contracted to revive only four elevators, apart from the ones that we are working on, where we have to source some materials locally, the kitchen and the hip. So the stairs will actually be coming in the second week, like I said, because that's when second week of next month. That is when the vendor will actually finish manufacturing this bed. So I'm trying to appeal to you, Honorable Minister. In this, I think people have got a misconception about escalators and Zao Elevators being the number one company in this country does not own any of these equipment. They are owned by the owners of the buildings. We are simply a service organization. We bring in this equipment, we install for you, and we maintain it over the stated periods that the manufacturer needs, as you can see. So the government can actually help us to make sure that foreign exchange stays in this country by coming to Zao. The number one elevator company in the world. It is not.
Can you distinguish for me Zao Elevators? What is? I'm talking about Zao Elevators, and again, I'm talking about what is.
All right. This means that Zao Elevators, like I said, is a Zambian company which has got a franchise for what is elevators.
Okay.
That is the franchise.
And the license. What would be the cost of this if you were to bring in one commercial or industrial or industrial?
I wouldn't say off the cuff, because what actually happens is we have to measure the dimensions.
No. Give me maximum. The biggest and the medium.
Yeah, I think my engineer can actually help me, because that is his.
This is UTH. You have to have an elevator from that pillar.
They know that.
Huh?
They already know that.
They know it. So where you can put it in the coffin, you can put the body in the bed, or something hiding inside. Not those ones I've seen at the Ministry of Health. The FSGBM is the one I was
at current exchange rates, the budget price, a safe budget price would be about 2.5 million.
2.5 million what?
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 Including installation?
Everything. Taxes, fans, programs, quarantine internet.
2.5 million. 2.5 million. Watch one. Good. That's the biggest.
Yes.
Good. Cost measure. The other competitor evade the challenge from Zao Elevators. It's good to bring the competitors together. Yes, please.
Good afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon. Thank you for giving up to come and present our company. I represent a company on a shingle lift. We are new in Zambia. We are 8 years old in Zambia. But we have installed many good elevators here. We represent a company on a shingle. Schindler is one of the top brands of the world from Switzerland. We are the franchise for Schindler. and we are maintaining similar and installing here in Zambia. Just to brief you, we have installed at the Minasoka Hospital, Schindler. We have installed at the Intercontinental Hotel and the Holiday Inn Hotel. We have installed at, recently at Mount Meru Building and the MTN Building also. We are also going to install new elevators at the Pyramid Hotel, the tallest building in Zambia, which is coming up. So it's like we are there in Zambia. We're trying to reach people. We are trying to make our base in Zambia because we are one of the most reliable and most safety concerned company in Zambia. We believe safety first, and that's which makes our brand separate from other brands. Installing two elevators at the adult male wing, and we are going to install or I would say upgrade three elevators at the newborn and baby hospital. But I would like to assure you, Honorable, that we are not doing it for temporary. We are doing it for at least, we are going to ensure that our work at least for remains here for 10-15 years, the lift doesn't have problems. We want to service it and we want to ensure it that the lift has lifespan of minimum 15 to 20 years. So that's what we believe on, that's what we are working for.
Is that a new one or the
The new ones. There are two new elevators.
Are installing the new ones?
Yes. And then we are upgrading all the three elevators at the newborn and we are maternity ward.
Sorry, sir. I just need clarification. How many units are you maintaining and how many new ones are you installing?
In UTH, we are going to install two.
New ones.
New ones.
That's under women and
newborn. Okay, yeah, that is specific.
In the women and newborn hospital, they're doing three.
Yes.
They're servicing three.
Let's not talk about the brand new.
Let's talk about the brand new.
Two that are located near the theater and the gyne emergency, and then one is in the maternity reception, which also serves as an obstetric emergency. So those three are the ones that are supposed to be serviced.
Let's talk about those. Are they temporary? Are you servicing them temporarily?
No, Honorable. When we are going to work there, we are going to ensure that the lift runs for at least 10 to 15 minutes there. We have ordered a complete new controller there, so that the lift has get a new machine specifically, and then it can at least run for 10 years. That's what we want. Those are electronic parts. Something can happen because of power fluctuations, but we are going to ensure that it's going to be at least for 10 years. That's what we have planned.
What is your guarantee period?
Okay, guarantee period is basically 1 year from the manufacturer.
You know an aircraft? An aircraft?
Yes.
You're an engineer. You know that there are no repairs on an aircraft? They wait for supervision. Aircraft, they don't repair, they just remove it. Well, given the period, they just remove it. There's no repair of any part on an aircraft. That's why I'm believing in you. If you want to replace, you just bring a brand new one, machine. They're very new. And apart from the box itself, but the machine will be brand new. Sorry, that your friend is saying, I'm going to put you in a tissue. I just want to hear. From a best option I can use that one. He will say no. Which are currently. I like this competition.
Yeah, it's actually good. Mr. Lillis, as I said in the first place, the people who are maintaining these elevators are moving the arena.
Mm-hmm.
Right? And I'm speaking of the Zambia. The example that I haven't told you, which has the elevators that you have attacked, I just gave you an example of Ladybug. They are actually put in, I won't mention the name of the escalators that they actually put there. But this only went up to 10 years.
10 years.
I have said to Google, we are the number one, we represent the number one company in the world. And ours is the guarantee of 20 years.
No, those are brand new.
20,
I'm
yes,
talking about these ones which we are maintaining.
Yeah, because that is not our franchise. We can't guarantee the durability of those pairs because that's not what we really represent as our elevators.
Okay, you want to come up with your own
precisely.
Yeah.
So given
that each there is not yours.
So, yes. So what normally happens, what is actually happening is after companies have actually been disappointed, right? They are now coming back to Zao elevators. NAPSA has to come. It was single sourcing. We never went into competition. Single sourcing because they know the brand.
I appreciate Silver. You, it's a loan, it's not your brand, but you are putting in equipment that is new, that is granted for some time, isn't it?
Definitely.
Thank you very much. Oh no, that's what I wanted. We are here. I appreciate you. Any comment from the engineer? Because you're engineer for the other companies in Zimbabwe.
Okay. I'll just add on to what my director said. An elevator is made up of two components,
mm-hmm.
mechanical
yes.
and electrical.
Yeah.
What we're working on, the spares that we're saying we're procuring that are coming are electrical.
Mm-hmm.
It's for that reason that we will not say that the existing mechanical will guarantee it for that long, but mechanicals, they can last up to 20 years. So what we are giving, the electrical system will last that long, up to 20 years. And the reason for 20 years is simply because technology improves. So there's no one who will tell you that after 20 years your phone will be the same. That's not how it works. So after that, we can then refurbish both the mechanical component or the electrical component.
But you're talking about Tempro. How Tempro is Tempro?
The Tempro is perhaps the repairs that we are doing,
mm-hmm.
we are working on two using parts from other elevators within. So that's why we said by tomorrow.
Okay. But when you have your other parts, then you replace those.
We can go beyond.
I think yet what remains is administrative. We shall try to see what we are going to experience in your ways. Would you people right on the ground want to feel quickly out of routine before waking up because the exam is at number 5? At least if I have 10 waking, you have to move very quickly. Administratively, on the ground, you want to move to another stage. Very important. The procedures in government. Out one of the 14 ways. For we think of a longer stay. If you are preparing to give us a good duration for more than 5 years, why not? And if it is cheaper, shall look at the options. New one, old one. We shall work around because our job is to look for resources and help you, madam. negotiate and make a viable problem. Meanwhile, when you didn't even release, see, who's more popular? You're not ready yet.
Yeah.
I will run and give you that one. Within them, whoever is quick and fishy and working hard, we just won't go on job. To run away from some of these handles we get with a little call. If we can move on as we go before, we go to a permanent solution. After all, first of all, analyze and see the solution. Ours to have all the 14 working. If I called you here, or you called me here, mine is to deliver to the people of Zambia, with or without money, especially hospitals. We have enough medicines. We need staff. We need equipment in order to make sure that we can avoid taking patients into India at a good cost. This is what has put us in the office. Please. Just a phone call. Last time I even gave you my number.
Yes, yes.
Just a phone call. May I can discuss with my colleague and we can discuss the colleagues at the and so for finance. Because you are dealing with life here. You are dealing with life. You are fair. Including Mr. Kabua. If he tell himself here, we shall even admit him. I can't expect to be taken out of this one. I have to plow the little money, the taxpayers' money back to us, saving them and saving us. Unless if there are any questions or any comments, I want to assure this people that we shall be on UTH. I was in Kitwe 1 week ago, Kitwe General Hospital. So we decided to go, we are doing some works. But we need to pay particular attention to Kitwe as well, including the elevators there.
Yes, sir. I just wanted to assure you that in terms of support for maintenance of the four lifts, that funds available to a tune of 2.8 million kwacha. And based on the funding that we have received from Ministry of Finance, we are going to move in some additional funds to ensure that the 14 lifts are renovated on time.
You hear?
Sorry.
You're the best. You're the best in the world. You're the best to give us a guarantee. Compete. Elevate yourself. There are elevators. Move on. Move on. I'll be happier to support you. Why don't give us best price, best quality, deliver on time, will be our best friend. To be our best friend. No color, no height, no nothing, but deliver the best. You'll be our personal holder. Maintenance is key. Just as I do, you need to find a way of keeping on maintenance. Especially if you use it for a long time, we need these people nearby. And there is also a good suggestion that we should be putting operators, temporary, permanent operators in there, rather than everyone comes here, switches all these switches, especially those from my village. Then they see those, they want us to be playing. They touch, they go up, come down, it's touching. Maybe we can look at that. As we employ casual workers, those will be cleaning the same lift. But maybe they can be helping us down, up, and whatever. That also has to be taken into consideration.
Yes.
They're saying that we deserve the cost.
People from the first.
I don't want to say much. At Northwest and the other side. Northwest, there are no Scotch cars. A person buys a vehicle, he removes the engine, just gets the bag and puts a poor and put an animal. The road is too expensive to buy fuel. It's supposed to use an animal. Otherwise, any question? Any clarification? Yes. What's your name?
Kalunda.
Kalunda.
Kalunda. Kalunda. From Millennium Radio. I have three questions.
Yeah.
My very first question is, you mentioned to say, apparently, one out of the 40 operators are not working. And I wanted to get, is it a confirmation to say, indeed, according to the headline that we saw today in the morning, that UTH is in a crisis because apparently, but those from theaters, emergency rooms are not okay as well. We had someone that called on our radio station. There are staff here, not mentioned their name. And then they said to say, apparently that's the situation here. Even in the ward rooms where people give birth, things are not working, the doors are not working. So is it indeed a confirmation to say UTH is in a crisis? My second question is that apparently, Levy also is facing the similar situation. I don't know if you've gone there, if you just confirmed other things. One thing that you mentioned again, my last question is that you mentioned to say long term solutions. What is a long term? Apparently, the two firms, what they're offering is short step. You, as government, what are you looking at as well in terms of long term solutions so that we don't face this problem again in the near future, looking at the fact that this is one of the biggest hospitals in the country? Thank you very much.
Let me begin the hearing before I give chance for another one. Yes, it would have been a crisis if at all the procurement process was not started. It was started in July. It's a question of availability of spares. The only thing is this, to wait until all the 14, or 13 rather, break down, that was unfortunate on our part. We should have started knocking on the doors when 2, 3, 4 were done. Now, we're waking up, and resources have not been available in the treasure before, and maybe nobody put attention to it. But now I'm telling you that we are particular to this. We put UTH, Ndola, Kitwe, Livingstone, all these hospitals to our heart. That's why we should congratulate them when you move. There's no that smell which you used to feel. Oxygen, we learned a lesson during COVID. Today, they've got their own plant producing oxygen here. I gave him my phone number. I said, don't follow the normal civil service channel. Call me if there is an emergency. And even when I came here, I talked about the lifts. We have donor funding to some extent. Want also to look at equipment. Most hospitals, the equipment is broken down. We've got 6 scans, 5 of them which came from Japan. We have some money somewhere. We've given instructions that money should be paid so that they are repaired quickly. It's our duty as this government to deliver, and I'll be going hospital by hospital. Make sure that we buy the equipment we deliver to the people. We don't want to wait for you, newspapers and the print media and the others, reminding us. We shall stand the door ourselves to see our problems. Only this morning, they say we are calling the PhD, Provincial Health Director. So this morning, I want to call them. So that we can list their problems. Of course, we shall not address them at once. We shall look at the most critical first, and then we go. We neglected this institution for a long time. But this government's eyes now with your president are open, wide open. We need equipment, and we're a ministry for both private and GRZ institutions. The only problem we've been facing at times is this. Procuring services in India is much cheaper than here in Zambia. This is a NEMA issue. These specs, I used to buy, I could buy them at 2,500. Bringing NEMA, they hiked them 5,000, 6,000. That's what has been happening. We need to move away from that. We need to control them. We need to regulate them. We are concerned. Your concerns are my concern. Who will never get sick? You and me. Both of us, we are destined. We have to make sure that we put our institutions in good service and order. The lifts, whether they carry the dead, who's dead? The same as our brothers and sisters. Our medical doctors quickly they are called. The issue that we are observing, which we have to put into perspective. One good thing is medicines are there all over. We have now got drugs for Zamsa and even small vehicles. They have gone everywhere. There will be no excuse at all. And also the issue of theft, we shall be marking. The medicines will be marked from the manufacturers so that whoever will be found selling medicines in a private, the law is going to be very tough, extremely. We are not playing. No prescription, go to his clinic. No, that one, no. If there is a prescription, we have to make sure that that medicine does not exist anymore. In the system, we have to let that bring it. It's meant for the poor person. It's meant for your brother. It's meant for your sister. It's meant for yourself. You are lucky today, I'm working physically. Tomorrow when you are sick, that's when you see how important the doctor is, how important medicine is. So we need to be disciplined. We need to care. I was reading there. The patient's rights charter is here, and the patient's responsibility charter there. There is one which you have not put, I checked around. What is the responsibility also for the doctor or medical and the healthcare provider, obviously. Those who have moved here is a patient, there's a patient. What is missing is what is the responsibility also for the provider? And also the provider, and also the responsibility of you and me who are here, who are not falling sick that particular day. If all of us come together, and we realize that it's a normal cause. We shall deliver the service that is required to our people. Right cost, right timing, and the quality. Really? This UTH is the biggest, yes. And we need to assure you that we shall give you support, sir. Doctor, Mama shall give you the support from my office. We are neighbors here. You called me, ready to come. I'm here. Don't waste time. Go through the channels. You can get my number. You got it as like 0 0 9 7. 0 9 7 7 75 3 2 3 1. I repeat. 0977-75-32-31. Elijah Muchima. Text me in the WhatsApp.
Yes, I'll
come on, this what's happening here. Yes, I'll rush. It's dedication to duty. Maybe you can add on some of the issues that you did on.
I think you have added everything. what really, you know, makes it not a crisis is that management has responded to rectify the steps they have taken. Number one, to undergo the length of procurement process to ensure that the contractor on site. I wanted to highlight that there is a history to the UTH lifts, the 14 lifts. In fact, if I'm not mistaken, I could be corrected. Before the movie brand of lifts, they were Zao elevator lifts. But I don't want to go back that far. I just want to say that with the government now giving us adequate funding from the Ministry of Finance and the regular flow of funding to the hospitals, these teaching hospitals and all the hospitals across the institution, they are getting grants every month on time. And that intervention has enabled hospitals like UTH to improve on maintenance of infrastructure, including lifts. And that's the money you get. We mentioned that there's 2.8 million available. We are going to send more funds. Kitwe, if I may touch on Kitwe, I think there is a transfer of about 2.5 million moving to complete the renovations of the roads and the wards and so on. So I think what has been a hindrance, particularly to the past 11 years, is inadequate and erratic funding to the hospitals. That's why most of the contracts, including the contract which was entered into to maintain the 14 lifts, was not honored. That's how the maintenance contractor disappeared.
He ran away
because they were not being paid. There was a contract which was not honored. So the most critical thing is funding, regular funding to the hospitals. And that's really the difference. That...
Yeah, to crown it all, the 14 will be waiting. Whether long term, short term, but long term. That's why we're getting a cost for one.
Maybe if I can give a rider to the question.
Wait first. We are going to do an analysis. We're going to do an analysis. Depending on the two samples we are putting, if he's going to maintain them cheaply and they're going to last, we should not rush to the long term. We shall go their way. But if they are temporal, they're giving us no certainty or endurance for a long period, we have just to resort to a long-term coming over all. Because some of it, they want their own brand. They don't want to mix the brand there. If it's their brand that they are granting you for 20 years. So that's management. That's what we're doing. But I promise you that we are going to address this problem adequately. One, there are grants which are coming. Two, we shall have some other interventions. Yes.
My radar was the contractor that is maintaining the elevators.
There are two.
Yes. What is the cost? Because available money is 2.8 million kwacha. And what is the maintenance cost for the old 14 elevators so that they can start operating? The fact that there's only 2.8 million kwacha and maybe grants will come through, but right as at now, it's 2.8 million kwacha. How much does it cost to maintain so that they come to operation, the old 14? Looking at the fact that the engineer told us to say bringing in a new elevator with everything is about 2.5 million kwacha. So maybe you can answer that question. And just another question. You mentioned to say your glasses, because of an Indian film, was at 2,000 kwacha.
I didn't say Indian. I said they were costing 2,500. Mm-hmm. But when Nima came with this insurance thing, people... Yes.
Okay, thank you for the clarification. Thank you for the clarification.
Please.
No, thank you for the clarification. Maybe you can answer.
Please, I think sometimes, I think if you hate me already,
The bank, the only, yes, there are 14 links that needs to be referred to overbank. But for us, we are only making charges for only four. It's not the offer.
What's the cost for that in terms of maintenance? The cost in terms of maintenance for the four?
It's up to UTH management to disclose that part.
Okay. Thank you.
Because that's the contract between us, I think. But it's not for me to say.
Just funds are
unless they are not getting
there's access to information law, so
in fact, I didn't know that we were going to face journalists today.
Thank you.
Hello? What you should be more interested in is that elevators are being worked on, and depending on what we see and with the amount of money, we shall attempt to continue, make sure that the 14 all of them are working before we go to a long lasting solution. If Shedwe is what he's saying is true, that they can last for more than 5 years, whatever they are doing, why not? And if it is cheaper, we have to compare with the new one, which will be costing at 2.5 million. Thank you for coming, and we are wanting people to leave on time. What remains is just this. I should thank the management for UTH, and they are there to use just the matter of. This is urgent all the time.